Recuerden pues, estamos a grabar con el municipal, luego mecánicos para los niños. A solo 15 minutos con la compra de dos grandes y divertido. Últimos días. Y aquí estoy ofreciendo pases de cortesía para los niños que ya vierten. Con las 5 oportunidades en adultos y entonces vamos a la otra cuadra bien pronto. Termis. Recuerden. Juegos mecánicos infantiles. Últimos días, Alta Hotel, con el Feo Municipal. Tenemos el punto, ruedas y cargos, piscina de pelotas, helicópteros, carritos, turmitas, sorpresas. Últimos días, Alegado de Feo Municipal.
America! I say to the people of America, this moment is our chance to enough to make of our own lives what we will. It is that pushes us forward. The American promise of life is that promise that's always set this country apart. It's a promise that says each of us has the freedom to make of our own lives what we will.
Welcome. This is Unceded Airwaves, a presentation with Borderlands Theater. I'm your host for the night, Adam Cooper-Terán, ensemble member with Borderlands Theater. This is part of their new livestream broadcast system. Want to thank everyone for tuning in. Going to be showing a smattering of different video pieces for the evening. Tune in anytime you want. It's a kind of long show, but hope you can bear with me as we're presenting this material. I wanted to also thank Borderlands with Mark Pinate and Milta for giving me the opportunity. This is a great space to be able to present a lot of material that I feel speaks to the work that I've been doing for the last several years. Some of the work that you'll see tonight is a mix of collaborations with a lot of different artists, and many I'll name and introduce in a minute here. But for some general house rules, I just wanted to give everyone a heads up that there's going to be a lot of flashing lights throughout this piece. A lot of extreme audio frequencies, a lot of drones, a lot of high and low sonic soundscapes that I hope won't deter anyone, but there's also going to be some language throughout this piece, and also images that might be a little bit disturbing, some violence, and images of child abuse, more concerning a personal project I've been working on. But separate from all that, it's meant to also entertain and bring you along for the ride. This is sort of a smattering of different work that I've been doing and working on from my library and archive of content. I also wanted to give a shout out that seems a little bit solicitous, but as far as throughout the night, I'll be probably blasting Borderlands Venmo. This is entirely made possible through grants that Borderlands has been applying for, and in lieu of the pandemic, a lot of creative people are needing to find new ways to be able to sustain themselves, and live streaming is kind of one way that we're trying to do that. And any support that you give is helping Borderlands not only pay folks like me to present material to you in this fashion, but down the road also create a platform that maybe theater can be presenting itself through a virtual space, and how to challenge notions around that too. I'm very much like researching and exploring, as well as a lot of colleagues and friends of mine too are in the same exact boat. There's so many places and people that I want to name and support throughout tonight, but more or less, the next series of videos will be a mix of some music work with some musicians that I've worked with, I've had the honor of working with, who I met a couple years back, is the Afro Yaqui Music Collective, based out of Pittsburgh, but also desde Mexico and Sonora and Baja. A lot of connections to a place that we're going to be going to tonight, as well as introducing some of my personal work around a solo project called ANNIA JEKKA, which in my ancestral tongue is roughly translates to shadow world. As we're moving through the piece tonight, just know that this is all broadcasting, not just through the airwaves, but through unceded territories, referencing unceded territories, and to acknowledge that I'm just here on unceded autumn territory as I'm broadcasting all of this. So, Unceded Airwaves. Next bit we're going to show is a suite of music by Afro Yaqui Music Collective. This is an epic piece. This is the Overture of the Sword, part of their larger project, the Mirror Butterfly Migrant Liberation Movement Suite. And I just want you to look up these names online, and you'll be able to dig further into the story that is about resistance from indigenous territories all over the world, eco-resistance. It's an opera, it's a spoken word piece, it's a fusion of improvised jazz and Asian and Afro cultures. from all of the players involved. A lot of the animated pieces that you might see are made by another collective as well. This is a collaboration, this next suite of music on video that a lot of people made. And as we're going further into the night, I'm going to probably just mix into a lot of other things. So I'll see you in a little bit.
Became a sword and struck a tree. I mean, right now, what are you becoming from your mushroom minerals?
You are the Lord, you are with us. You are the Lord, you are with us. In fire.
Yeah.
Are you willing to wait? To live with worlds beyond your world?
You can make the world.
The calendar is coming. You must prepare. There is a calendar from above and a calendar from below. There's an hour before and an hour after the hour you have known, unmarked on any clock, unprized by the gray mediocrity of lord and master. There's a mirrored river that flows from the rising sun into the midnight sun and back again, and it will show you how the sword became a sword and struck the tree. It will show you how the sword became a sword and struck the tree. A sword like this one. A sword like this one. A sword like this one. A sword like this one.
All your gifts of nature, labor, fertility, I take them all. I degrade the conditions of what you produce. I'll give you chaos. I expand and make you pay the expense in order to exist. I commodify your nature, your labor, your fertility. Devalue that in some new drive or acquisition and disaster. I don't want you stable. I don't want you to rest. I want you anxious and suspicious, full of envy, disaster, and mistrust. Fatigued from every increase as a new boundary to exceed. I want the regime of profitability. Well, that's what I'm after myself, so you have to make do with sweat, obesity, and hunger. You'll have your alienation and fast, fast food. I always feel like I need something more. Crave something more. I'm craving this, not that. I'm craving this, not that. I'm craving this, not that. Synthetic bond, because it's natural bond. Manage and manipulate. don't question the hustle. Throw that away, it's done, you're done. I need the new, I need the youth. I wanna deny aging and death. It's a race, I have a very short window to prepare myself. More crowded, more frantic, get down, I need more dead downs. Deportation, lotto culture. Sword time is uniform and then sugar cane and corn defeat the soil. Sugar cane and corn. Sugar cane and corn defeat the soil. Oops.
Thank you for watching another video. I kind of wanted to pick up from where I left off one day last week whenever I made a video and I was talking about fear and how important it was to not give in to fear. You know, we can act and we can prepare and we can do whatever we need to do from like a grounded, centered place without becoming panicked, you know, letting fear dictate our actions. When you're face to face with something like that, there's nothing you can do but either allow it to completely and absolutely control you or force yourself to get really, really still. You know, whenever we're scared, we automatically just start looking for something outside saying, you know, either the government or religion or whatever it is. We want somebody to tell us something that alleviates that fear because it's so unbearable living in that fearful state all the time. What I did learn about fear is that you can't fight it. You know, you can't forcefully make yourself stop feeling it or battle it in some way because you're really just fighting against your own body's chemistry. What you do, what I learned to do to cope with it was to feel it. You're going to feel the fear, but you don't have to get attached to it. You just sort of let it go through you. You register its presence. You bring your conscious attention to the fact that you are experiencing fear. You know, anytime you're feeling something or anytime, like say fear, an overwhelming burst of fear, your body is also releasing chemicals at the same time. That's a huge part of what you're feeling. You know, you're feeling adrenaline surges and all sorts of hormones going into fight or flight mode. Whenever you start to catch it, before you slip into it and start engaging in all the fearful fantasies and thoughts and everything else, you also stop that process of those chemicals being released into your bloodstream. One of the things also that I learned, I want to go into a few of the exercises that I would do to help with this process in future videos. And that's why magic was so important to me, is because that's what ceremonial magic is. It is ritualistic actions that allow you to become conscious of a lot of unconscious things and exert more control over yourself. A lot of times people will take, in ceremonial magic, they'll take a motto to remind them of something, to inspire them in some sort of way. And I am sorry, my brain just completely went dead. I forgot what we were talking about. Give me a second.
deadline passed and another is weeks away for the Trump administration to reunite families separated as a result of the zero-tolerance policy at the border. We still don't know how many of those children are being housed in Tucson at the Southwest Key facility.
We do know that this facility has done this for at least 4 years now. They have housed children for that amount of time. There's no exact word from the facility as to how many children are currently inside, but the city of Tucson did issue certificates of occupancy that approved 325 residents for the facility. Some of the key job postings do offer some more insight into how the facility operates. These job postings include healthcare, education, and security positions, and some of those positions specifically calling for a lead teacher, youth care worker, and caseworker.
The state wanted to see proof that every employee here at Southwest Keys is undergoing a background check. Tonight, we're getting an inside perspective from a former employee who says she's surprised and sorrowful to hear the allegations of abuse coming from inside these facilities.
Came to Tucson in 1856. Mr. Oury had a lot of doubts when he just before dawn, he was a cattle rancher, newspaper publisher.
Many of them were women and children.
City council member, Pima County. At 16, he came to Texas looking for adventures. He was at the Alamo in 1836, but was sent on an errand just before the famous battle started, so he missed it. At 23, Billy was still looking for a good fight. He joined the Texas Rangers. In the Texas Rangers, he got to shoot Comanches in his main job. One of those times was at the Battle of Plum Creek. The Battle of Plum Creek actually started March 8, 1840 in San Antonio. Comanche chiefs and their wives had come to make a peace treaty, but the Texas soldiers killed most of them. That summer, there was one chief still alive, Chief Buffalo Hump. He led a raid in revenge against the Texas whole killed all his friends. Buffalo Hump and his men stole a lot of horses and killed some of the white people and their slaves along the way. On August 11th, Oury and the rest of the Texas Rangers found Buffalo Hump at the Plum Creek. They killed 80 Comanche warriors, but Buffalo Hump got away. By 1849, Billy Oury and his new Mexican wife, Inez, ran off to California to strike it rich as 49ers, but he didn't find any gold. In 1856, the Oury's decided to go back to Texas. They stopped in Tucson on the way home and never left. Bill and his friends, like Sam Hughes, Hiram Stevens, A.P.K. Sefford, and John Wasson, were getting rich as cattlemen and merchants on the land that being the home of the Apache for hundreds of years. They got really mad when Apaches like the Chiricahua led by Cochise would raid their ranches. So on April 30, 1871, Bill led a vigilante group of about 140 Anglo-Mexican and Tohono O'odham men to Camp Grant. Camp Grant was about 50 miles north of Tucson. This was where the Arivaipa Apaches had surrendered as prisoners of war. Starving and tired, the Arivaipa Apaches had turned in their guns to the U.S. Army months before. A different band of Apaches had allegedly attacked the San Javier mission and stolen horses and mules a few weeks earlier. But the Arivaipa were defenseless, so that was who Oury and his men attacked. In a speech to the Pioneer Historical Society, Bill Oury said,
"Not a single man of our company was hurt to mar the full measure of our triumph."
More than 100 out of Viper Apache were murdered just before dawn as they slept. Many of them were women and children. Some of the children that didn't get killed were sold as slaves in Mexico or given to rich families in Tucson to work as servants.
They would go to sleep crying and we would ask them what's going on, and then we had one kid saying, "Oh, it's because I don't know where my mom is." And then we had another one and another one. That's when we started noticing that we were getting kids that were being separated from their parents.
I'm here to say I'm sorry that I was a part of that. I'm here to say that change needs to happen. I'm here to say that the waste needs to end.
This man is opening up about what he saw and what he did inside Southwest Key, the nonprofit agency running the facility on Oracle Road that houses migrant children. We'll call him John.
Put that sign up when you set up a big kid. That represents blood spilled by Native Americans protecting this land from the invader. Yeah, that's right. That's right. You don't want to hear the goddamn truth, do you? Get on, bitch. You don't want to hear the truth. That's what that flag stands for. All the Native Americans you killed the Fletcher houses here. That's the truth.
Sorry, why'd you start that fire?
I felt like it, and because I'm just saying, screw our president.
Neighborhood Barrio Viejo in downtown Tucson, Arizona. The barrio is an eclectic mix of old homes, boarded-up homes, new homes, and businesses with a unique blend of Mexican-style design. Many of the owners add their own personal touches, expressing their creativity and sense of color. The area is so unique historically, architecturally, and culturally that you cannot miss it when you are in the area. If you want to open the doors of your own new home and start expressing your creativity, please give us a call. Maribel Valdez, your realtor, will always be there for you.
Customs and Border Patrol has reportedly entered into a $26 million contract with the U.S. Division of Elbit Systems, an Israeli military contractor that has a facility here in Marana.
Thrown out them people are caught in the midst of colonial policies that are now militarizing our lands, from just the amount of Border Patrol agents to checkpoints to drones to just the overall surveillance of our community.
Physical walls have not only failed to slow illegal immigration, but have also caused a rise of migrants' deaths. With higher security, people still attempt the crossing, but in more remote and risky border areas. At the same time, walls can cause environmental problems, such as the erosion of mountains, the dumping of erosion waste into rivers, and consequential flooding. Physical fences also restrict the movement of animals, impeding their ability to find mates, food, and water sources. At this point, virtual walls seem to be a more feasible solution. However, some Americans are worried about the privacy issues related to high-tech surveillance. Others have expressed concerns about the health safety issues related to the use of lasers, radar, and biometric technology.
M87864. It is round me over, bro. Yeah, it is round me over, dude. They ran me over, bro. Yeah, I'm laying on the floor, dude. Alright, bro.
Hope everyone is feeling all right. Now that was a non-slot. Just want to mention that a lot of that main last segment that you were witnessing was a personal work known as ANNIA JEKKA, or Shadow World. And it's the first piece. It's a three-channel installation, really. It's meant to be performed in front of people and not as we've kind of experienced it tonight. That work is actually probably about a 50-minute show in its own right. A lot of it is focusing on the landscape of Arizona, specifically the Tucson Basin, over several millennia. It takes snapshots in time. The idea behind the show is using the Tucson Mountains as a primary landscape or setting for exploring the different layers of history that have kind of been influencing each other. Or I like to make the argument that all the land that we're on is layers upon layers upon layers of lived experience and history of many different kinds of people. And if you take any kinds of trauma or genocide or history that is not in essence healing or in harmony with the land, then that creates cycles of violence that we are always witnessing. If anyone's from here, whoever knows anything about this place being so close to the borderlands, the show itself is supposed to be a kind of healing and acknowledgement to that, this land. And the idea behind the show is using video and multimedia tactics to be able to present a work that is it's meant to be a ceremony. Previous to that, it was more of the work that I was mentioning earlier from Afro Yaqui Collective. I wanted to read a little bit about the group itself because I feel like it's just such a dense project, mostly built around the collaborative team of Ben Barson, Giselle Rodriguez, Peggy Choi, and Ruth McGrath. We're the core team working with probably an ensemble of dozens of people. And the team was basically loosely inspired by this revolutionary Zapatista myth relating to local ecology, sustainability, and rebellion told through metaphors of a tree, a stone, and a river. The Movement Liberation Movement Suite is online. You can check that out further. The next section of the show has a lot more to do with working in resistance. Some of the collaborators or folks that I've worked with tend to be kind of instigators in disrupting public space. And one of the groups that we're going to show like some content of now that's a collective that I was involved in for several years is the Psych Map was the name of the collective. It was like a local group of artists, mostly of comprised of David Sherman, Koich Ni Siamon, and Heather Gray. And our work was as video artists and filmmakers were combined to challenge public spaces and notions around how video can be presented publicly, and breaking out of different narratives that have to do with the way that video is seen and interpreted. Some of that work is like very tongue-in-cheek as well, but a lot of the themes of tonight's show, I'd just like to say, are very much about looking at place, looking at space, looking at where we're based, and in essence, like, finding resistance in that, or creative resistance through that. The show is called Unceded Airwaves for a very particular reason. Even in trying to promote this show, because I rely heavily on remixing media and movies and films that have already existed, or referencing in some way, and taking like literal footage from those movies, I get flagged more often than not when just like putting up a video that might have a sample from another movie. And I think it's interesting that just like we're now in a time where seemingly we have all this access in the airwaves to be able to present our work or our knowledge of things or any art that we have, and DJ can't get a break. And it's hard. All of us are struggling to be able to put our work out. But if an algorithm like flags it, or a bot flags it, then, I mean, what does that say about how we're presenting our material? How can I avoid that? We'll see. Tonight, I got some other work that's like sampling some kind of other. We'll just see if the bots flag it. Also, just, you know, keep wanting to put it out there that this is like a brand new kind of format and series, the way that Borderlands has been needing to and requiring to survive and thrive. Our live stream broadcast system is really intended to be sort of a space to not just do this kind of canned curated theater or curated media art that I'm doing tonight, but giving space for actual theater to be experienced. And I think that there's a lot of possibilities for this medium. For anybody who's watching this, if you're a creative, physical person, a performer or an actor, like, I want to challenge the way that the Zoom format of the Matrix format is set. We're all living in a very particular time now, so I think it's very important to be able to find ways that we could stimulate our minds and be creative, and also to collaborate still, even if we're isolated. That doesn't mean we're completely alone, that we could still have meaningful connections with people. Yeah, PsychMap. PsychMap was sort of a first project into, I'm going to provide more commentary as I'm showing this. There was sort of it was very much about challenging public spaces. This is the Parade of Lights in 2015. If anyone doesn't know, every year in Tucson downtown, the local powers that be put on a very quaint holiday parade that brings out a lot of different organizations, nonprofits, and gives a lot of support to the city. Just as a alternative to a lot of the imagery that we've experienced in these spaces, and going against, or maybe diverging from the Christian corporate model of what Christmas is, our group decided to intervene the space. And so we literally, David Sherman literally built like this cart. The two projectors sections where two projectors could sit on. And another cart was pulling a generator that we were able to power a sound system and the projectors as well. And the idea was just playing and on the fly, mixing video and sound that could be challenging the space, or just giving an alternative. So some of that is acknowledging the Barrio Viejo that we're walking through, They're showing photos of the barrio before it was torn down in the 60s. Phrases that were very much part and alive with the indigenous movements that were going on, the land resistors that were protesting. And also showing like pagan imagery. So just showing that whatever Christmas is referencing a lot of other things. That whistling is the work of Raven Chacon, also. Yeah, basically, there weren't any people that were watching. Like, you usually have to have a permit to just go into the parade. But at the very end of the parade, where the line was, we just kind of jumped in, and nobody really did anything about it. Only until we went through the line and then ended up at the Masonic Temple. And the local Masonic Temple is right downtown, which is, like, right off the where the route was. But kind of certain parts of people were still kind of meandering and gathering. So a lot of our sound was deafening to other people. It was kind of intruding in other people's space. Okay. And the cops got called.
Yeah, I'm not saying I don't believe that. We did get called.
I understand.
Well, you can see what we're running. We're running commercials, and then Chinese labor footage for making holiday decorations in China.
And you should all know your rights around that, by the way, with cops. You never have to give your identity if you're not breaking the law. We'll give you a hard time, but you never have to. Now, if you're black or brown, I don't know, but knowing and exercising those rights is something that this was kind of like the first time really in a public space that I was trying to do that too. And yeah, I know I'm white passing, and it's very based around how I look and what I'm doing, but I think everyone just needs to know your rights also. Ultimately, a lot of the project that was Psych Map, because it kind of existed in this very specific time that we were able to create not just intervening spaces, but it was about creating installations. It was about going specifically to different sites and sampling the sounds that come out of the landscape, that sampling the visuals and the imagery that comes out of the landscape, and being able to find just new ways of presenting material and giving a commentary about things, because I think politics weaves in and out of a lot of all of our work that was in the collective and in personally too. A lot of the work you're seeing is very political in nature, but you know, we diverge from that too. I mean, one of our great friends, Eric Schlappi, decided to make a music video and asked Psych Map to produce it. So we're gonna show Poseidonis from Eric Schlappi. We're gonna go on to get a little bit weirder for the evening, unless you think it already is too weird. But I would say sit tight, get your mocktails and your cocktails, as my friend Sib Sally would say, and we'll check in a little bit.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to the alien camp. Hello and welcome to the Sunshine Camp. We hope you enjoy your stay. Hello and welcome to the Sunshine Camp. Hello and welcome to the Alien Camp. We hope you enjoy your stay. Hello and welcome to the Sunshine Camp. We hope you enjoy your stay. Hello and welcome to the Sunshine Camp. We hope you
The proposed South Mountain Freeway would begin at the existing I-10 and Loop 202 Santan Freeway interchange. The new freeway would complete Loop 202 by replacing the Pecos Road connection and connecting the East and West Valleys through Southwest Phoenix. The proposed freeway would provide three general-purpose lanes and one HOV or carpool lane in each direction. The freeway would follow the Pecos Road alignment and, as much as possible, use land currently owned by ADOT. The 40th Street exit and entrance ramps would provide access to homes to the north, as well as a new retail outlet center.
Unceded Airwaves. I'm your host, Adam Cooper-Terán. You're here with me under quarantine. Whether you like it or not. And if you don't like it, turn it off. Go to bed. That last half was work with Verbobala, spoken video. Which I'll introduce in a minute, but yeah, the music, Jescom, Puzil, from their debut album, main album. Before that was French artist Olivier Sagazan, mixing up, mashing Psychic TV, or more specifically, Comb Transmissions with Phoenicia. I always like to try to give credit where credit's due. A lot of samples I'm pulling from go back really, really far. So bear with me if you're not named. But I try to acknowledge and never want to be in a position where I'm vulturizing people's work. A lot of this is just in honor of the collaboration and collaborative nature of how I work. That last section with all the landscapes was pieces and snippets from the work I've built over many years with my mi compas, mis hermanos, mi familia. It's hard to put into words right now how strongly I feel for Logan Phillips, Moises Regla, and Emmett White. Our collective Verbobala spoken video was such a interesting multimedia collective born out of two nations and two places that integrated so many other performers and artists. And one of them as well is Naila Altamirano, is another collaborator, colleague, hermanita del sol y la luna también. And the work that we produced as Verbobala was very much built out of living in these borderlands. And so some of those sections are from the piece Sonoran Strange, which became a book of poetry Logan Phillips published some years back, but that built an entire show that we toured throughout the Southwest and had a installation element to it. It was like a giant orb that we usually propped up in public spaces in the open and projected with two different projectors and performed in the orb and outside of it. And it was just sort of a document or record of a lot of that. Some of that content was from there. I'm going to show some other pieces from Berbobala in the next section here, as well as, if you can't tell, I'm trying to see my set list. This is like some of the advantageous and disadvantaged ways of, as an audience, that you're witnessing me like figure out my set. I'm going to show some work with Verbobala, some video art by Moises Regla. I don't know what else to say. This is going to all flow into another piece of work of a larger project that I developed that was called Shooting Columbus, and that was built with Fifth World Collective, mainly with the core unit of Denise Uhara, T. Loving, Ryan Pinto, Rachel Bowditch, and myself. And that was a project we presented locally here in Tucson, but it covered a lot of ideas and content that you've already been seeing tonight, having to do with land, indigenous rights, indigenous resistance, creative resistance, and going to show some segments of that, a lot of which was inspired by Klee Benali. And for those who don't know Klee, you should get involved with what he's doing right now for the Dene Nation, and everybody needs support, obviously. We're going to keep going. Probably got another hour's worth of content, so if you're getting tired, take a break. Most of this stuff is going to be archived online through Borderlands YouTube and Facebook, so if you're not wanting to engage this right now, because I could, bear with me. There's a lot of energy thrown around right now. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show, and I'll check in soon.
Doce, dieciocho.
Inmigrantes de Centro y Sudamérica, principalmente del Ecuador, de Brasil, de Honduras y de El Salvador. Se trata de 58 hombres y 14 mujeres, sin información preliminar. Hay muchas preguntas todavía por responder, Daniel, pero las autoridades argumentaron que está todo bajo investigación y que no se pueden dar más líneas de los elementos que tiene para su
cuerpo. Pero con otras, porque hablábamos de 62 cadáveres que fueron tirados. Hablamos en México, en Tamaulipas, una de las zonas fronterizas.
Eso es lo que está acaparando los espacios en los medios de comunicación y la atención también de todos los mexicanos. Se encuentra la Secretaría de Marina.
¿Qué tan seguido se consume cadáveres en una producción?
54.
En el municipio de San Fernando, en el fronterizo estado de Tamaulipas.
61.
Que no es una narcofosa, se trata 65. De un hallazgo.
68.
Que una persona herida llega a un,
70.
A una
71.
Estación de mando de la Secretaría de
72. Fueron 72.
No tienen cara ni nombre, mucho menos tuvieron voz. Por querer ir para el gringo, la muerte se les costó. Escapando de la migra, al norte querían llegar y con el pinche cártel se fueron a encontrar. Sin nada y al gran sueño se quisieron aferrar y en Tamaulipas los narcos la droga querían pasar. Centroamérica, Brasil y el Ecuador, 72 fueron los muertos, solo uno se salvó. El gobierno preocupado sus crucecitas construyó, un lo siento a las familias y todo se olvidó. Ya nadie habla de eso, pues nunca sucedió. Los narcos siempre al frente y todo bajo control. No fue el desierto el pollero, ni el tren ni la migra. Fueron los Zetas que se los quebraron a sangre fría. Una calaverita y su altar en México para recordar. Otra muerte de migrantes que no se podrá olvidar. En medio de la guerra con velitas, se la venimos a recordar. Al pinche gobierno y los narcos que nomás nos quieren chingar.
رح ترجع لنا في يوم ورح نضلنا احنا متحدين الاحتلال ورح نضلنا صامدين وجه الاحتلال لحتى ترجع لنا ارض
ما سؤال میکنیم این سازمان ملل و این شورای امنیت جز این که در خدمت صاحبان قدرت باشند چه سودی برای بشر امروز و مظلومان جهان امروز دارند
called, please come forward with your attorney. 12-33284 MP, USA versus
Julio Benjamin Soko Bakiak.
12-33314 MP.
Ricardo Salas Mesta.
Sí.
12-33332 MP.
Oscar Cabrera Sales.
And Cesar Toro Rivas Aguilar, that one is going to be a plea, so we don't have to do that first. 12-33266 MP, USA versus...
Jose Guerrero Medina. Present.
12-33268 MP.
Orlando Favila Duran. Present.
273 MP.
Veronica Lopez Esparza. Present.
279 MP.
Daniel Ramos Daniel. Present.
283 MP.
Jacobo Castellanos Reyes. Present.
12-33289 M.
Luis Santos Cruz. Present.
12-33294 MP.
I don't even belong there, and the country that I grew up, they don't want me here, so it's like kind of...
And your parents messed up by not making you a citizen.
Exactly, yes.
And you might have messed up by committing offenses and now not being able to become a citizen.
I accept it.
Okay. So I wish you the best of luck, but there's nobody in this room that can help you.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Mr. Hernandez Rivera is sentenced to 60 days. Mr. Mayoral Mendez to 150 days. Ms. Perez Banderas to 30 days. Thank you all. Have a nice day.
Sí, él te ve de frente. Él está hablando. Tu traductor te está traduciendo en español. Y pues tú solo tienes que decir si me llamo. Por ejemplo, yo, si me llamo Fabiola Ramos, si soy yo. Y si entré ilegal al país. Y ya. Sí, fue poco. Solamente te van a decir lo que tienes que decir. Lo que te conviene decir a ti. Que me convenía decir que yo sí era culpable. Y que sí aceptaba el tiempo que me daban. Y solamente eso es lo único que me dicen. Son como 10 minutos.
How do each of you plead to illegal entry, guilty or not guilty?
Culpable.
All guilty.
Counsel, any legal reason why the court should not accept these pleas?
This land once belonged to all the people. My people are the Yaqui, or Uemi, and the Tonaatam. But because of the Gadsden Purchase in 1854, the land was separated by an invisible wall. Then there was a real wall, and then the wall became even more real. This wall separated our families, making it difficult to travel to ceremony. As I speak, we Yaqui are observing Lent, 7 weeks of ritual, ceremony, and prayer. During this time, we travel to our place of origin. So Yaqui travels back and forth across the border, and my family in Mexico travel back and forth from Rio Yaqui to South Tucson for ceremony. And now that one, the one who thinks he is the U.S. president, he wants to build a wall and make Mexico pay for it. My family in Mexico say, no way. The wall also separates animals too. The rabbit, the frog, the snake cannot travel for their food sources. But the Mexican government has its own type of tyranny. They want to take away the river rights of the Yaqui people. They built a giant dam to divert water from the Rio Yaqui to the capital, Hermosillo. My Yaqui family in Mexico have been fighting for generations to stop the desecration of the land. And for my Otom side, the border cuts right through the Tonon Nation. Here it looks like a simple fence, but the border patrol constantly surveils it and doesn't want you near it. Our people used to inhabit all the land, far down south into Mexico and up to Upper Phoenix and Tucson, of course. But the U.S. government drew a border, told us to stay on this side if we wanted to become citizens. But we said, no way. We are going to stay right where we are. And because of that, we now have people in U.S. and in Mexico. We are not abandoning them. They are still our people. The border doesn't stop us from knowing who our people are. This will always be our land, and by that I mean not just Otom and Yaqui. We share it with all Mexicans, other indigenous people, and other cultures too. No one can take away the knowledge of our people.
Thank you.
Unceded Airwaves. Last section of the night, also. But what you just saw were pieces from Sonoran Strange, from Vedible Bala, also made in deep collaboration from sections of pieces that were made with Jason Aragon, Pan Left Productions, Denise Uehara, and it was actually one of Borderlands through Mark Panate that I met him through. Was a project that Borderlands was also involved in, Dreams and Silhouettes. Oh, there's so many dense pieces here, so I hope you're enjoying yourselves. I would like to just also give deep gratitude to Borderlands for giving me a set for the night, space where I could show some new work, or old work as well. This is kind of like such a new platform for me too, to learn and be open about presenting material that usually you just have to find in layers upon layers of the internet. But to curate work that goes back like 10 years for me or more is really awesome. I'd also just like to acknowledge just like how this time to present material is a very potent and interesting time, and for anyone that's interested in seeing more of these live streams, I did another one almost a month ago, for another project, but I would want to take you to check out my Linktree. Put up the text here. I have my own personal address. Linktree/AdamCooperTeran. It's also on my Instagram profile. The last section for the night, I'm going to feature another piece from Afro Yaqui Music Collective. It was actually the first video project that I made with them that ended up debuting in Iraq for a water forum that the government and a bunch of other organizations, NGOs, and artists. Tell me more about it later, Ben. But maybe the video itself samples a lot from the Shooting Columbus project. Another piece, collaboration with Lana Del Rabies, now known as Beata. Sam Ann, wonderful, amazing artist in Phoenix. Tucson born and bred. And we'll close out the night with just a final outro from ANNIA JEKKA. But I hope you've enjoyed the evening. I'll probably slip back in at the very end. And see you on the other side.
Thank you. Thank you. take their last breath, push back and forth, push to nowhere. Everybody's hating, fool without a care. Waste of war comes down like the night. What will break you first, you or what you fight? What will break you first, you or what you fight?
Thank you. no hell below us.
Above us only sky.
Imagine all the people
living for today.
Imagine there's no countries left.
It isn't hard to do.
There's the television. It's all right there. All right there. Look, listen, Neil, Brad. Mercies. We've got to be any more things to make things anymore. It's all automated. What are we for then? We're consumers. Okay. Buy a lot of stuff. You're a good citizen. But if you don't buy a lot of stuff, if you don't, what are you then, I ask you? What? Mentally ill. Back, Jim, back. If you don't buy things, toilet paper, new cars, computerized blenders, electrically operated sexual devices, stereo systems with brain implanted headphones, screwdrivers, miniature built-in radar devices, voice activated computers.
Take it easy, Jeffrey. Be calm.
Imagine no possessions.
I wonder if you can.
No need for greed and hunger.
Brotherhood of man, sharing all the world. You, they say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one.
I hope someday you'll join us, and the world.
Unceded Airwaves. Thank you for coming out, checking this out, tuning in. Again, if you want to support local Southwest Chicano theater, here's our Venmo if you want to support. I also have my own personal work. If you want to see that, you can find me on my Linktree. I want to thank everyone for coming out, tuning in. That's my set. I'll probably be doing more of these as the months go on, and there's more work to share and more stories to tell. Thanks for coming out. Thank you, Borderlands. This is Unceded Airwaves.